My husband got stuck in the storm inside his ex-wife's house 3 months ago. Later I find out she's 3 months pregnant via Facebook. I have no idea why I keep suspecting it might be my husband's. Forgive me, but I am losing sleep over this issue and I can't seem to control myself. Context: 3 months ago my husband, aged 37, got stuck in his ex-wife's house while he was dropping off their 7-year-old son because of bad weather. He couldn't drive and spent the night there. It was no big deal though, this was the first time he spent the night at his ex's. Our entire 3 years of marriage. Recently, I read his ex-wife's announcement on Facebook that she was expecting, 3 months in, and kept referring to the baby as her son's brother sister without adding half, which might mean nothing since many people don't pay much attention to stuff like that. I call my stepsister just sister so I can understand that, but to be honest, the timing is what made me concerned. I did the math and couldn't help but think of the possibility of the baby being my husband's. My husband was acting normal, which what made me hold my tongue and keep my thoughts to myself, but once his ex-wife started attempting to call often and meet often, I had to bring it up with him openly given how uncomfortable her behavior made me recently. He didn't take it well at first and said he was not having this conversation because of how off map it was, then explained he no longer had feelings for his ex after she cheated on him, and said he wouldn't have a child his son with her in the first place had he known then what he knows now. He called me crazy to even hint there's even a slight chance the baby is his, and acted hurt for days because I accused him of something he'd never do and insisted it wasn't his fault the bad weather kept him from going home and forced him to spend the night at his ex's house. He said he wanted to go wait at the gas station but his son wanted him to stay and he slept in his room, then he left first thing in the morning. Like I said, the timing is what gets me, as well as her attempts to get close to him, like visiting often for private conversations that my husband refuses to share with me. I've been told she never wanted divorce and wanted to work things out, but my husband couldn't do it. He hated her. I spoke to my stepson about that night and he told a slightly different story. He said his dad left the room twice for good periods of time. I tried to get him to be more specific and remember for how long he was out the room. He said he didn't know since he fell asleep shortly after his dad left the room the second time. I felt frustrated. I really wanna stop dragging and dropping this in my mind, but something is preventing me from doing that. I am struggling to have some peace of mind since the ex announced her pregnancy and I don't know why I have such strong feeling something is up. I can't talk to her since she's vicious and hates me with a passion, so I'd only imagine how she'd react to what I tell her. I don't know if she and her current boyfriend were trying for a baby, they haven't been together for long and they didn't seem serious as far as I know. My sister said I have the right to feel uncomfortable with this. I want to get this out of my head and go on with my life, but my husband keeps refusing to discuss how I am feeling. Let Alpine try to give me reassurance, for my concerns. I figured I might get some outside perspectives from a third party. You'll find out once the kid is born if she comes after your husband for child support or lists him on the birth certificate. But please stop asking your stepson about that evening because it's unfair to put him in that position. Yeah, poor kid. It's uncomfortable and unfair. Besides, children are impressionable and they have a tendency to respond based on what they think is the right answer you have in mind. It's not conscious lying, but more not wanting to go against what an authority figure is suggesting, so it makes sense to me that the child is affirming her suspicions. First off, don't involve his kid, don't put him in the middle by asking him what happened and to account every things his dad did that night. That is so wrong. If you're curious, think something is up, act, that's between you and your husband, not him. Tell your husband you'd like to have a serious talk just to put your mind at ease. Maybe the ex just wants you to think that since the timing is so perfect, that way she make things difficult, not your home front. Has her boyfriend said anything on Facebook or been involved in the posts? If the ex has a history of trying to make your husband stay close, she could be deliberately pretending it's his to mess with him, or even to mess with you. If she's not asking him for support or anything, I'd just believe your husband though, and drop it. Second story, I 23 female was our ped earlier this year. My boyfriend 23 male of 9 years refuses to have ex with me and I think he is gonna break up with me. Trigger warning, mention of sexual assault. This is gonna be a bit long, sorry for that. I 23 female met E 23 male in the 6th grade when we were both 11 years old. We were best friends since that, really inseparable, practically joined by the hip. We started dating when we were 14 and never stopped. We were the typical teenage couple. We had our fair bit of stupid fights, but overall our relationship was pretty mature given our ages. E family practically adopted me when my parents died when I was 17. My parents died in a car accident and they were strangled for their family, so I had no one else to go. His mom loves me and my relationship with the rest of his siblings is pretty good. He has one older brother 25 male and two younger sisters 19 female 17 female. I considered his family as my own. They helped me so much since my parents died. They let me move in with them. They paid for my college and rent. I live with E and they pay our rent. They are really supportive of us and his mom have a heart of the size of the entire ducking world. I swear, E is tall 6 feet 3, absolutely gorgeous, easygoing, funny, really ducking smart. He speaks 5 languages and is attending med school. Everyone likes him. Me on the other hand, I am pretty common. I would give myself a 7-10 on a good day. Despite all that, he was always jealous and insecure about me. He is absolutely terrified of me cheating on him. His aunt cheated on his uncle who later committed suicide. They were really close and that give him some severe mental scars. Given that he was always a bit controlling of me hanging around with male friends and make me promise him that I would never cheat on him 1,000 times. Earlier this year in February, I started spending a bit of more time with my friends and as a result, I wasn't spending much time with him. This started our biggest argument so far. He argued that I was prioritizing my friends' male friends specifically. He tried to make me cut one of my closest friends that he didn't like it. I wasn't gonna do that and we ended screaming at each other. This led to a day that I was supposed to go to a party with my friends at night. He asked me to no go there because my friend was going to be there. I told him no. Before I left, he told me that he was feeling sick. He told me that he was feeling a headache and a slight fever. He asked me to stay home and order some food and watch a movie with him. We started to argue. He screamed at me and I left. I am gonna try to make this short and not graphic. I meet with 3 of my friends there, drink more than I should, got really drunk, went to lay down in one of the rooms in the house that the party was happening, fell asleep, and woke up with my 3 friends raping me. I was able to scream and one girl who was in the bathroom heard me up and came to help me. Soon other people started showing up and in the end, the guys who did it were beaten up too close to death. I was taken to a hospital after that. 2 of the guys are in jail right now and the other was able to dodge prison because he didn't have taken his turn yet. To say that this whole thing ducked me up is an understatement. I was diagnosed with depression and PTSD. It was bad, really ducking bad. I started having this panic attacks where I couldn't breathe and the only thing that made me feel better was E. If he was there I didn't have any panic attacks, but if he left for more than 30 minutes now is a bit better. I am able to be away from him for about 7-8 hours without feeling terrified. I started to freak the duck out. I was probably one of the few people who were grateful for the lockdown. LOL. A mix of obsessive attachment with anxiety. My therapist said, he was my goddamn hero. He cooked for me, made sure that I was eating, made sure that I was taking my meds, drove me to my therapist and psychiatrist appointments. He started showering with me because it was the only way that I was comfortable being nude. Don't ask me to explain why. He held me down when I started sobbing at random moments at the day. I used to have night terrors and the only way to this day I can fall asleep is with my head on his chest. He is the only person who makes me feel safe. Basically he and his family, his mom helped us a lot. She was the one who delivered groceries to our apartment because he couldn't leave or else I started to panic, were the ones responsible for me not killing myself. Our ex-life was pretty good before the incident. We lost our virginities to each other when we were 16 and we were each other's firsts and only in everything, even kissing. He has an insane high libido. For him we could have X 7 times a day and he could keep up for hours, but we normally did once or twice a day and I always blew him at least once a day. He always pressured me a bit for more X and was always hurt when I refused, but overall our X life was pretty healthy. After the thing, he never ever mentioned or tried to initiate X or any type of thing like that. I started to feel comfortable with kissing him around the end of August, but he only gave me short pecks and he didn't seem to enjoy them. These days when I tried to give him a more elaborate kiss, he pulls away. In the middle of September, I was finally feeling good enough with myself to have X again. I put on some fancy lingerie and tried to initiate, but once he saw what I was trying to do, he pulled away. Gave me a kiss on the forehead, said that he was tired and went to sleep. This doesn't sound like a big deal, but it is. Ever since we had X for the first time 7 years ago, he never shot me down when I tried to initiate. Not even once. And the longest time that we spent without having X was 4 days before the whole thing. Obviously, every time that I tried to initiate X, he always gave me an excuse. He was not in the mood, he was tired, he was busy, and like I said before, he has the libido of adult video star, and I caught him masturbating before, so that didn't change. My twisted mind thought he was cheating on me, even though that the max time that he spent away from me in these days is for about 4 or 5 hours. So yesterday I snooped through his phone. Yes, after all the things he has done for me, I did this. Yes, I am a horrible girlfriend and he wasn't cheating on me, but I find out something that I honestly don't know if is better or worse than cheating. He was talking to his older brother about us. The main facts that I discovered were this: that he blames himself for letting me go to that party, that every time I tried to initiate X, the only thing he is able to think is the other three guys being inside me and how wrong the thought of other guys being inside of me made him feel sick, that how our special thing for us was lost. The special thing is that we lost our virginities to each other and never had X with anyone else. He used to say that in the future he will brag to our future grandchildren about how in the age of hookups we only had X with each other. This may seem dumb, but it was something that he was really proud of, because he is really romantic in that sense, and his parents were each other onlys and they were pretty much the perfect couple. That before the incident he bought a ring and was going to propose to me, but he feels like he started to see me more like one of his sisters, and that the lust that he had for me now feels like fraternal love. His brother responded that he had to suck it up and stay with me at least until I get totally healed. He said to him that he wasn't sure if I was going to heal completely. I read all these things last night, read it, and I really don't know what to do. The thought of not being with him makes me feel terrified. We were supposed to grow old together. He had our whole life planned already. We even discussed baby names. He is absolutely perfect and I don't want to lose him. I have a therapy appointment next Monday, but I don't think I am able to keep this to myself until then. I am really desperate here. Any advice is really appreciated. Sorry for the long post. I feel like I needed to vent a little. Before I got to reading his text portion of the post, I already knew what they were going to say. This is exactly how I would feel in the same situation. I have been in a similar situation as your boyfriend. Your only option is going to be to talk to him about every one of these items, as well as the snooping. Also, he will not bring this up, and this is going to sound heartless. He is likely mad at you for going to the party despite his warnings. He won't say it to anybody because it would make him seem like a jerk. This is an I told you so moment where he can't say it, but in his mind it is true. He knew it was a bad idea to go to the party and tried controlling you as much as he could, faking sickness, but in the end you went. And the worst thing that could have happened, happened. I can almost guarantee he is angry with you for going. It isn't your fault or your boyfriend's fault. It sounds heartless, but that doesn't matter. You are both victims here, but you will probably need to apologize to him for going to the party in addition to the rest of the conversation that you need to have. Tell him what you saw and talk to him. I am sorry for what you have gone through and what you will go through, because he is likely on his way out. I had a buddy whose girl went through something quite similar. He was simultaneously angry for failing to protect her and angry that she put herself in danger despite his request not to go on the skiing trip. They tried couples counseling. It did nothing for them, but might for you. I would suggest that he get to therapy as well, to help him process the event. Third story, IF27 caught my BFM30 masturbating on our ring. My mom's 37 female boyfriend 40 male constantly has a problem with me 16 female. Basically what the title says. For some background info, my parents separated when I was 3. But they've always separated their issues with each other for my sake. I know my mom cheated on my papa, but he's never made her out to be the villain to me. They agreed that I'd be living with him with visitation to my mom's place. Both my parents had new partners. My papa 38 male married his boyfriend 38 male when I was 8 years old, and I've always seen him as my dad too. They had my sister when I was 9, so she's 7 now, and our family is honestly great. Our dads love each other endlessly, so my sister and I have just grown up in a pretty loving and caring environment. I love my mom too, and like I said, my dad has never said anything bad about her to me or my sister. She didn't exactly settle down like my dad did, and she has had a lot of guys come and go. It was a little hard when I was younger and would get attached. I've learned since then that I shouldn't be doing that. My mom's current boyfriend of about a year always has some kind of bone to pick with me. He's pretty clear that he doesn't like having me around or the fact that I get attention from mom when I'm around. My mom doesn't like hearing complaints about him, and she does say certain things about my dad. She's never liked the fact that I call my papa's husband dad. Her boyfriend also has a problem with the fact that I'm living with them when he doesn't even like me in the first place. I honestly don't know what he wants from me. It's getting hotter where I'm from, and I usually sleep in shorts and t-shirts. And he has a problem with me walking around like that, and it makes me uncomfortable. He also makes weird comments that insinuate that my dads would look at me like I'm not their daughter and would essentially sexualize. He also doesn't get why they're even married and raising children together. These kinds of comments are another thing that makes me uncomfortable. He's also mentioned things about my body like I'm showing off my figure and my boyfriend would be lucky. I don't know what to do. Would it be bad if I told my mom that I won't be coming over anymore as long as he's there? I don't know if I should tell my dads about them either. My dad, especially, is super protective of me and sister and would never let anything bad happen to either of us or my papa. I have no problem just living at home with my dads and sister until my mom can sort things out with her boyfriend if she does. I just don't want to completely cut contact with my mom. Too long didn't read. My mom's 37 female boyfriend 40 male constantly has some kind of bone to pick with me. He constantly badmouths my dad's both 38 male and nitpicks everything I do or things they let me do. He has a problem with me walking around in my PJs and says things that make me uncomfortable. The wonderful thing about having great loving protective parents is that they will fight your battles for you, especially in cases like this. You don't have to tell your mom if you don't feel comfortable. You can tell your dads and they will very likely support you through and through and break the news to your mom for you, leaving the creepy BF completely out of it. You make the decision. Tell your dads you don't want to go anymore, understandable if they want some explanations, and then from there, they can take the news, then it'll play out among the adults. Your mom can decide to side with you or her BF, and if she sides with you, great. Boundaries will hopefully be enforced. If she doesn't, well, it sounds like you just won't be going to see mom anymore. Of course, as this is all going down, it's normal to feel worried or some kind of way. But keep in mind you're doing what makes you feel safe and secure and comfortable. Tell your dad, this guy is a wild creep. I grew up in a hot place, regularly wore shorts, tanks around my dad and brother. Never had to worry because it's my dad and brother and they didn't sexualize me. He sounds like a jealous BF and it's ringing all the alarm bells. If you can leave your mom's house and stay with your dad's, I know you don't want to cut contact, but if your mom cannot prioritize your safety, you don't have a choice. Hit like. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to our channel.